expansion into Paraguay for hydroelectricity and take surplus electricity, help build up their grid. And it's all just moving along nicely. And the opportunity to buy Bitfarms operations, that took us, that was the big scaling element that takes us from 100 megawatts of electricity to over 300 megawatts just in Paraguay.
Hello, you're watching Proactive. Joining me is HIVE Digital Technologies Executive Chairman Frank Holmes. Frank, great to speak with you. Your full year 2025 was described as a transformative year for HIVE. What were the key decisions that unlocked this next phase of growth?
Well, it started about a year ago, and that was the expansion into Paraguay for hydroelectricity. And take surplus electricity, help build up their grid. And it's all just moving along nicely. And the opportunity to buy Bitfarms operations, that took us, that was the big scaling element that takes us from 100 megawatts of electricity to over 300 megawatts just in Paraguay. So that's the big scaling. Then we did our HPC for AI, and what we saw there is our revenue is what last year was 10 million. In the 6 months now, it's 20 million, and it will scale to $100 million. And we announced 2 days ago that we bought a data center that will repurpose from what they call Bitcoin mining into high performance computing. And that's where I am right now at MIT, taking a course with 100 CEOs from 80 countries on how AI is going to change the future and augment our professional skills and career, not eliminate them. So it's really exciting to be here with people from all over the world. And here we are building data centers, and our revenue and HIVE just on the Bitcoin mining will go from $115 million last year to about $415 million of Bitcoin at $100,000. A lot of people believe Bitcoin's going to a quarter million. Well, that just means we're going to scale even more. And scaling really is you're not hiring as many people, but you get profit margin expansion with the revenue. And that's what we're scaling both our AI business and high performance computing with NVIDIA chips and in Paraguay with our Bitcoin mining facilities.
Frank, how does that scale translate to shareholder value in the near term?
Well, you got to think of the revenue. I think we have about key 25 employees, and we're going to go from 115 million to 400 million and add the AI. We're going to push 500 million in revenue, and we're not going to be hiring thousands of people and hundreds of people. So that means we should be able to deliver that margin expansion. And we have been profitable. And that's a nice part is we announced our year-end results for March. We did 115 million in revenue. We had EBITDA of 53 million. And it was a tough year because we had to go through this another transformation of going from IFRS accounting over to USG AAP GAAP. So we did all of that, and our operating income was still $25 million. Now I'm going to expand to about, I think about $100 million is where I look at it this time next year, the operating income would be, and the EBITDA should be something like $200 million.
Frank, just looking at Buzz HPC, revenue there tripled this year. How big can this division become relative to mining, and how do the margins compare?
Well, it's a great question. When you're either Bitcoin mining or you're in high performance computing with NVIDIA's chips for machine learning, etc., they're in data center business. That's what you have to realize. And when you're in Bitcoin mining, it's a lot less expensive to build a data center, but it's a stepping stone to go to high performance computing. So when we look at Bitcoin mining, it's $1 million per megawatt of electricity of infrastructure and equipment. But when it comes to high performance computing, it's $10 million per megawatt. And then you still have to buy those very expensive chips. So they are different, but they both need data centers.
Frank, with 25 exahashes per second targeted by year end, how confident are you in reaching that milestone? And what does it mean for HIVE's competitiveness post-halving?
Well, this year we hired two great leaders, one to build out our HPC, Greg Tavares, and for Paraguay, we have another young man in Gabriel Lamas, and he's been doing a phenomenal job. So no one expected us to already be at 11 exahash. And so we're just every couple of weeks we're adding an exahash. So I think it's pretty straightforward. Unless there's some logistics equipment not getting delivered in time, it's pretty straightforward where we're going to be.
HIVE continues to generate strong adjusted EBITDA, as you've pointed out. How are you thinking about capital allocation going forward, including dividends or buybacks?
They're not on the scope. The scope right now and the focus on the strategy is grow, grow, grow. Build, 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 because you can take a look at Open Chat's numbers in only a couple years from 1 million subscribers in a day. Now it's talking about 500 million active users. They hit $10 billion in a couple years, $10 billion in revenue. That just tells you how immense this boom is in AI and how it's going to change the world. And that's why I'm trying to learn as much as possible of being here at MIT with my peers.
Frank, I hope you enjoyed the rest of that MIT conference. Good luck there, and thank you very much for the update today.
All right, happy investing.
Frank Holmes, Executive Chairman of HIVE Digital Technologies.